Previously at Mathville Mansion. We've been solving Professor Puzzleworth's challenges, practicing multi-digit addition and subtraction problems as we've journeyed through the Great Hall, the library, and most recently, the study. A big red button. I wonder what it does. Hey mathematicians, it's Justin again, and it's finally time to find out what the big red button does. Give me a second. Ugh, I want to enjoy it. A secret passageway through the bookshelf? This mansion is full of surprises, and it looks like more puzzles could be found through here. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to use problem-solving strategies to solve multi-step word problems. You'll also be able to identify and fix mistakes in addition and subtraction equations. Have your guide and notes ready, and let's discover where this passageway leads. All right, after working all day in the study, Professor Puzzleworth could take his secret passageway to the dining room. Wow. And our first puzzle is inside that empty frame. Let's check it out. An artist is hired to create a new painting for the dining room. Professor Puzzleworth has $23,800 saved up, but the final price for the painting is $19,275. Ooh. There's a question at the end, but it's all blurry. I think we have enough information to figure out what the question could be, though. First, what's this story about? An artist is going to make a new painting for the dining room. Do we know how much the painting will cost? Yes, the final price is $19,275. What else do we know? Professor Puzzleworth has $23,800 saved up. Does he have enough to pay for the painting? Yes, $23,800 is greater than $19,275, which means he has more than enough. So, what's a question we could ask about this information? We can use the amount of money Professor Puzzleworth has and the cost of the painting to figure out how much money Professor Puzzleworth will have left after paying for the painting. And sure enough, that's the question. So would adding these amounts together help us figure out the leftover amount? That would equal a much larger number. We need to figure out how much he'll have left after paying for the painting. So subtraction would be most useful here. Pause here to use the subtraction algorithm to figure out the leftover amount in your guide and notes. $23,800 minus $19,275 requires some regrouping to solve. Since there's also a zero in the tens place, we'll need to go to the hundreds place first. Regroup 100 for 10 tens, and then regroup 110 for 10 ones. We'll need to regroup again once we get to the thousands place. Once we're done, we'll learn that Professor Puzzleworth will have $4,525 left after paying for the painting. Solving that revealed the new painting, and it's pointing to the kitchen. I bet that's where we'll find our next puzzle. Ooh, wow. Wait a minute. Professor Puzzleworth be here somewhere? It seems like he was in the middle of making homemade pasta and left us our next puzzle in the spaghetti. It's not very hygienic, but let's check it out. Professor Puzzleworth is preparing for two different events at the mansion. For the first event, he needs 23,708 servings of spaghetti and 14,685 servings of garlic bread. For the second event, he needs the same amount of spaghetti and garlic bread as the first event, plus an additional 8,216 servings of meatballs. How many servings of food will the professor need in total for each event? That is a lot of spaghetti, garlic bread, and meatballs. And we already know the question we need to answer. how many servings of food will the professor need in total for each event? We can do this. The first event needs spaghetti and garlic bread, right? And the second event needs those same amounts of spaghetti and garlic bread plus meatballs. Pause here to find the amounts needed for each event in your guide and notes. Ooh, check it out. There are answers on the back of this puzzle card. First event, 38,393, and second event, 36,509. Do those match your answers? I got the same answer for the first event, but my answer for the second event was different. There must be a mistake here somewhere. Let's break it down. Starting in the ones place, 3 plus 6 equals 9. In the tens place, 9 plus 1 equals 10 tens, which can be regrouped as 100 and 0 tens. In the hundreds place, 1 plus 3 plus 2 equals 6 hundreds. Ooh, how did they get 5? Maybe they forgot to add the regrouped 100. In the thousands place, 8 plus 8 equals 16 thousands, which can be regrouped as 1 10,000 and 6 thousands. And in the 10,000s place, 1 plus 3 equals 4. That must be it. They forgot to add the regrouped amounts. The correct answer for the second event should be 46,609 servings. Wait, what's this? It looks like the correct answer revealed a phrase. Go to the kitchen pantry? There's probably more waiting for us there. Whoa, now this is an organized food pantry, but it's a dead end. Where could we possibly go from here? Ooh, this puzzle should help. Professor Puzzleworth is completely out of flour and pasta sauce. So he adds 22,785 jars of flour and 13,315 jars of pasta sauce to the pantry. Then he removes 4,318 jars to use for another event. Based on the story that's being described, what do we need to figure out? We know how many he adds at the start, and we know how many he removes for another event. This means we can figure out how many jars of flour and pasta sauce are left in the pantry. Now that we know the question, pause here to solve it on your own first. We'll review it together when you're done. How can we figure out the number of jars the professor put in the pantry? By adding 22,785 and 13,315, which equals 36,100. Then the professor removes 4,318 jars. How can we figure out how many jars are left? By subtracting 4,318 from 36,100. There's an answer on the back of this card that says 31,781. Is that right? It's really close, but not quite. What do you notice about their work? It seems they regrouped 110 for 9 ones, but it should be 10 ones. The correct answer should be 31,782 jars left in the pantry. A ladder? I knew there'd be a clever way out of this dead end. So, what have we learned today, besides the fact that Professor Puzzleworth is clearly the master of puzzles, pasta, and home design? Well, now you know that word problems can be solved by thinking through what the story is describing. You've also learned that addition and subtraction algorithms can be used to find solutions and catch mistakes. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to apply what you've learned about addition, subtraction, and problem solving. We'll find out where this ladder leads in our next lesson. Until then, remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, every effort adds to your success. See you next time!